That's the only time we refer to it as co-brokered. That's what that means, that there are two separate real estate firms involved, and each one of the buyer and the seller have representation in that. Well, this is an example of what a commission split would look like in a co-brokered transaction. In a co-brokered transaction, you're going to have the total listing commission, which is usually some percentage of the sales price. It's most often some percentage of the sales price. Remember when we looked at the exclusive right to sell listing agreement, we saw that line, percentage of sales price. Could it also be a flat fee? Yeah, absolutely. But most of the time it's some percentage of sales price. And then that total commission gets split up into two pieces. Now that split is not necessarily an equitable split. It doesn't have to be 50-50. And so when you start reading these math questions, sometimes you'll see that indeed it is not 50-50. Most often they don't give it to you as 50-50. But the key is, what is 50 plus 50?
100.
So if 50 plus 50 is 100, doesn't that mean that that split always has to add up to be 100% on that level? And it does. That's what I mean here by this little bracket that I've got drawn from one side to the other. The listing side commission plus the selling side commission has to add up to 100% of the total commission. Does everybody understand that? And the same thing is true when you start splitting up the commissions down here at the firm level. The listing side commission is going to be split between the listing firm and the listing broker. They each keep a piece of that transaction. So they're actually getting a piece of a piece. Right? Because here's the hole up here. Here's the first divvying up into pieces, and this is another whole level of divvying up into pieces. And those of you that join a real estate team, you're going to add a whole other level of splits down here with this listing broker. One would get split up again, and the team leader is going to get a piece, and then the broker on the team is going to get a piece. So there could be even another level of splits. Now, you won't have that on the test. This is what you need to know for test-taking purposes. The important thing to remember is also each one of these split levels adds up to what? 100%. If you remember that, and you can essentially draw this chart, and I call this the commission tree. That's my cutesy little nickname for this. If you can draw this commission tree, you can always figure out commission math. And you have this in a slide in your math formulas, but I've got it in here as well. Those of you that have looked through the math formulas, does this look familiar? Does this look like something you've seen just looking through there? This is the same thing as you saw on the previous slide. Just now, we've applied these arrows over to the side. If I'm coming from the top to the bottom, I am multiplying, and if I'm going from the bottom to the top, I am dividing. Now, I've also added a couple of labels onto this tree. I put at the top over here something that didn't exist on the previous slide. What is it?
Sales
price. And I put on the bottom something that didn't exist on the previous slide. What is it?
Commission.
So here's what I mean when I say if you're working from the top to the bottom or you're working from the bottom to the top. These questions only come in two varieties. They either give you the sales price and ask you for the commission, in which case you would be working from the top to the bottom, which means you would be doing what?
Multiplying.
Or they give you the commission and ask you for the sales price, which is bottom to top, so you would be dividing. Does everybody see how that works? It's just a visual trick to remind you, are you multiplying or are you dividing? The nice thing about the tree is, if you can fill this tree in as you read the question, then the math takes care of itself. Because, for example, if they give me a sales price of $500,000, well, I'm just going to fill $500,000 in up here at the top. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And they would tell me a total commission. They tell me a total commission of, say, 6%. And then you read through, and what they tell me is that the listing side keeps 60% of the commission. Well, if the listing side is at 60%, what must the selling side be at over here?
40%.
You see how this works? I'm just filling things in. If Travis is the listing broker, and he keeps 75% of his commissions, well, I'm going to write 75% in over here at Travis, and if he's at 75, what's his firm at?
25%.
And if they then told me this information, could I calculate what Travis would get paid in that transaction?
Yes.
All I'm going to do is follow the tree from the top to the bottom. I start, because they gave me sales price, so that's the number I first put in my calculator. $500,000. And what's the math step going to be if I'm going top to bottom? Multiply. $500,000 times, and what's the first commission number I come to? 6%. Times 6%. I'm not even going to stop. I'm going to keep going because I got to get all the way to the bottom, right? Again, what's the math I'm using? Times, what's the next I get to get to Travis's side of the transaction? Am I going to be using the 60% or the 40%? The 60%. So take that number times 60%. And then we said Travis's split was 75%, so it's going to be times 75%. So what the tree tells me to do on this question is to type into my calculator $500,000 times 6%. Times 60% times 75%. Does that make sense for everybody?
Yes.
I'm literally just following it down. And if you do that, what do you come up with for a commission for Travis on that transaction? $13,500. That's easy, right?
Yes.
It doesn't get any more complex than that. This thing simplifies it to that point. So let's take a look at one. And you've got it in your slides here, and we've got it up here. So we're going to read it together, and you try to go ahead and fill in a commission tree of your own. Now, I'm going to skip to the next slide to show you how I would draw this. This is how I draw my commission tree. Right? That's all I do. Where the left side is going to be the listing side, and the right side is the other side. What's the, what's another name for that other side, that right side? The, it's the buyer side. What's another word for the buyer side?
Selling.
Selling. The buyer's side of the transaction is the same thing as the selling side. Okay? There's a couple ways you can try to remember that. A couple tricks. Number one, When you put the ing behind it, there's only two words that end in ing, listing and selling, right? So one's got to be on one side of the transaction and the other's got to be on the other, correct? Well, I'm pretty sure all of you know which side is the listing side at this point, right? Well, if the other one has to be the opposite, what are you left with? The buyer side, correct? That's one way to remember it. Another way to remember it is where the work is happening. Who's actually selling the thing? Well, the listing broker's putting it out there for sale. Who's showing it? Who's taking somebody over there to see it? Who's writing up an offer on it? That's all the buyer's agent, right? They're the ones doing the work of selling the property. In fact, when somebody goes to show a listing of mine, what do you think I say to them? Go what?
Sell.
Go sell it. That's exactly what I say to them. Go sell it. Please. They are the selling side. Does that make sense for everybody? All right. So in reading this question, you've got a blank slide there for you, and I'm going to get to the blank slide and fill mine in as well, but I want to read through it up here first before I take it down. And I want you to try to fill it in, and then I'll fill mine in, and we'll see if we match up. It says, Travis represents the sellers of 118 North Main Street in Garner. So I'm going to already fill Travis in. Which side of the tree is he going on? If I back up to this tree over here, which side of it is he going on? The listing side. So he is the listing broker, correct? Okay, so we're going to fill him in that spot. In Garner, and executed an exclusive right to sell listing agreement with them, authorizing payment of a 6% listing commission. Where are you going to put that 6% commission? Up at the top, correct? It goes at the top of your tree. And agreeing that firms representing the buyer in the transaction would be compensated with 45% of the total fee. So now we're down to that middle level split. We're right here, right? Because it says they've agreed that they will compensate firms representing the buyer with how much money?
45%.
I know I've got 40 up here from my previous example, but 45% is going to go on the selling side. That's the buyer's side of the transaction, right? Well, if it's 45 over here, what must be over here?
55.
Fill that in, because you never know when you get to the end of the question which way you're going to need to go down the tree, right? So always, if they give you one half, go ahead and fill the other half in. So you're going to put 45 on that side and 55 on that side. How much would Travis be paid on the transaction if the final closing price was $418,000? And again, where's that 418 going to go? All the way at the very tip top. And he had an agreement with his firm, Take It All Realty, for him to keep 65% of his total commission. So let's look at what my tree would look like in this case. We said that Travis represents the seller, so we put Travis over here on the listing side. He's got a listing agreement authorizing a 6% commission. I'm going to put that all the way up here at the top. Everybody agree so far?
Yes.
They agreed that firms representing the buyer in the transaction will be compensated with 45% of the total fee. So this is the buyer's side. They're going to get 45%, which means over here we get
55%.
How much would Travis be paid on the transaction if the final closing price was $418,000? I'm going to come in here at the top and put my price. And he had an agreement with his firm, Take It All, so Take It All down here because it's his firm, where he keeps 65% of his total commissions. Well, that 65% is going to go right here with him, which means Take It All gets how much?
35%.
Is that all the information they gave us?
Yes.
And what are they asking us for here?
How much did Travis make?
How much Travis is being paid? Does everybody agree with that?
Yes.
So, they're asking us to go from the top to the bottom, right? Mm-hmm. Which means we're going to be doing what?
Multiplying.
What do we start with?
$418,000
sales price times
6%
listing commission, and since we're going to Travis, we're going to the left side of the tree, times
55%
times 65%. Easy, right?
Yes.
Can everybody do that? Good. Good. So I want you to take a look at this one and work on it for just a second for yourself. By the way, what do we come up with for Travis' commission on this? Everybody knows we have the same number. How much?
$8,966
and a dime.
Yep.
Sarah is working with Betty Beyer on the purchase of a home in Zebulon. After having Betty sign an exclusive buyer agency agreement as provided by the North Carolina Association of Realtors and the North Carolina Bar Association. That's a mouthful. What does it mean?
Nothing.
All we care about is the exclusive buyer agency part. We don't care who it's provided by, right? Betty was paid $3,850 at closing. Betty's firm, You Got Screwed Real Estate, keeps 70% of all of Betty's commissions. That's why it's called You Got Screwed Real Estate. And she was cooperating with a listing firm that kept 60% of the total listing commission. If the property had a listing commission of 5%, what was its sales price? So just quickly, before you even fill anything in, are you going to be working from the top to the bottom or the bottom to the top? Which one did they give you?
From the top to the bottom.
They gave you commission, and they asked you for sales price. So you're going to be working from the bottom to the top, which means your math is going to be what? To divide. Yep. They're just seeing if you can do the math.
Gotcha.
Tara asked, why would they do this in real life? Why would you say that somebody got paid this much and how much was the sales price? And most likely you wouldn't, even though people that see a $49,000 commission are trying to reverse engineer the sales price most of the time. But and you really aren't doing it that way except on the test. Okay. They just want to see, can you work with these numbers? Got it set up. I'm going to start drawing it. First time I did it on one of those, or the last time. So it says Sarah's working with Betty on the purchase of a home in Zebulon. So I'm going to go ahead and draw my splits here. Sarah's on which side, the left side or the right side?
Right side.
Yep. She's over here. On the buyer side or the selling side. After having Betty sign an exclusive buyer agency agreement, yada, 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 Betty was paid, I'm sorry, there's a typo in there. It should say Sarah is paid $3,850, right? We don't want to pay the client. We want to pay the agent, right? So Sarah is paid $3,850 at closing, not the buyer, but the agent. And it should say Sarah's firm, you got screwed real estate, keep 70% of all of her commissions. Or you can switch the first names out and keep all the rest of them the same. One way or the other, it's the agent who's getting paid, not the buyer themselves, right? Everybody following me with that?
Yeah.
We're good on correcting that typo. Just notice that. All right, so I'm going to write it as Betty since it repeats it as Betty over and over. I'm going to write it as Betty up here on the solution. Okay? Betty was paid $3,850 at closing. Betty's firm, you got screwed real estate, keeps 70% of all of her commissions. So this is YGS Realty. And they keep 70%, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Which means Betty keeps how much?
30%.
She was cooperating with a listing firm that kept 60% of the total listing commission. So the cooperation between the two firms happens at that level right there, right? Everybody agree with that? So is the 60% going to go on the listing side or is it going to go on the selling side?
Listing.
The listing side, 60%. Which means over here we've got?
40%.
If the property had a listing commission of 5%, what was its sales price? 5% goes at the top, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And we said if we work from the bottom to the top, we're going to be
dividing.
So what number do we start with?
$3,850.
We always start with the dollar amount. And we're going to divide that by?
30.
What's the 30. First number we come to?
30.
30%. Because that's how much Betty got paid, right? And then divide that by what?
40.
40%. And then divide it by?
5%.
And what do you come up with for the total sales price of that house?
They got screwed. 641.
641,667.
$641,666.67.
I think you got disagreement behind you.
Yeah.
Might want to check here. You want to know why I have disagreement? You want me to pick on you, right? Why does she have disagreement? Do I need to throw it on the floor and step on it? Is this a calculator?
No.
No. Don't use them. $641,666 is the sales price of that property. I'll check it again, make sure you get it. Okay. Is everybody good on that?
Yes.
Did it confuse anybody? No, you're not good on that. Can I do it again? 30 and the 40. Follow it from the bottom to the top, right? What's the number you started with? 3850. And what math are you doing?
Divided,
right? So we're not thinking here, because thinking is dangerous in the math in this class, right? Divided by, and who got paid that amount of money? And then what was Betty's split? Okay, so then that's what you divide by, right? And now you go up to the next level. And what's on that next level? Divided by?
40.
Divided by 40%. And then you go up to the top level. Divided by? 5%. You just work your way right back out, all the way to the top. I like it. No thinking required. It's the best kind, right? Is everybody okay on that? Did that work for you that time?
Yes.
Good. Good. Everybody okay on that example? All right, you got one more to work on there. In your packet. Carlos represents the buyer of 16 South Elm Street as an agent of Get Some Realty. He's cooperating with another brokerage on a transaction, and that firm is charging their client a 7% listing commission. After executing the exclusive right to sell listed agreement with the seller, we want some real estate. That's real convenient that we want some is cooperating with Get Some, isn't it? We want some real estate has offered compensation to cooperating selling firms in the amount of 40% of the total commission. If Get Some Realty makes $1,980 on the transaction, what was the sales price of the property? So real quickly, before you even start filling it in, did they give you sales price or did they give you commission?
They gave you commission,
and they're asking for what?
Sales price.
So they gave you the bottom of the chart, and they're asking you for the top of the chart. We're working from the bottom to the top. Are we multiplying or are we dividing?
Dividing.
When we're upside down, we're dividing. Okay? So let's start to fill it, or you go ahead and fill it in real quick. I'll give you about 30 seconds yourself to fill it in, and then I'll start doing it. I'm sorry? You don't have to use it? You like working from the top to the bottom? Sometimes they give it to you in reverse. When they don't give you the sales price, you can't go that way. Carlos represents the buyer of 16 South Elm Street. So which side of my tree is Carlos going to be on?
Right.
He's going to be on the selling or the right side, right? The buyer's side of the transaction is over here. So there's Carlos. As an agent of Get Some, so GS Realty is the buyer's agent. He's cooperating with another brokerage on a transaction. That firm is charging their client 7% listing commission. Where's that 7% going? Where? All the way at the top. Remember, there is a difference between a listing commission and a listing side commission. The listing commission is the total commission being charged on the transaction. Now, why do we call it a listing commission? Because what's that agreement you sign that authorizes it? Exclusive right to sell listing agreement. It's a listing commission because it is signed between a listing firm and a seller, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that 7% goes all the way to the top. That's the total commission, the total listing commission. After executing the exclusive right to sell listing agreement with the seller, we want some real estate. So this is WWS Real Estate. Offered compensation to cooperating selling firms in the amount of 40% of the total commission. This is where you need to read it three times to make sure you understand what you just read. Because whether you get this question right or wrong is going to depend on which side you put that 40% on. Would y'all agree with that? After executing the exclusive right to sell listing agreement with the seller, we want some real estate, right? Agreed or offered compensation to cooperating selling firms to somebody over here in the amount of 40% of the total commission. So where's the 40% going? Is it going on the listing side or on the selling side?
Selling side.
Which means over here is
60%.
If Get Some Realty makes $1,980 on the transaction, so here's Get Some, what was the sales price of the property? Now we already said we got commission, they're asking for sales price, we've got the bottom, asking for the top, what are we doing?
Divide.
We're dividing. So we start with the dollar amount they give us, which is $1,980, right?
Mm-hmm.
Divided by what's the first split. We don't have it, right? We don't know what Carlos's split is. Guess what? They might do that to you on an exam. What's the first number you encounter on the way up? That's what you gotta go with. That's what you gotta go with. How much is Carlos getting paid? He's salaried. He don't get paid, I guess. I don't know. But we only have what we have here, right?
Right.
And the first number we have back up that tree is 40%. So 1980 divided by 40, and then what's the last number we have to work with?
Seven.
Divided by 7%. What do you come up with for the sales price of that property?
$70,714.
$70,714?
Yes.
28 cents.
And some change. Everybody okay with that? Have we blown anybody's mind so far tonight? Good, because I will tell you, that used to be one of these things that blew my students' mind. Not trying to pat myself on the back, but that thing has made all the difference in the world. Because I used to teach it that you had to read that and go, okay, well that's 40% of 7% of a number, and you had to type all that in, and people couldn't string it together. This gives you sort of a flow to it. Good?
Yes.
Good. Now, there is a whole other type of math that relates to listing properties for sale and commissions. It's called seller net pricing, or just seller net. The word net we haven't talked about yet. Gross and net are opposites of each other. Gross is before what's deducted. And taxes are a form of an expense, right? So gross is before any kind of expenses are deducted. That $49,000 commission check I wrote today was a gross commission to him, because if he spent any money on driving himself out to that property, or buying signage for that property, or marketing that property, doesn't he have to deduct his expenses from that to see what he really made on that transaction? Does that make sense for you guys? Well, after he deducts out those expenses, what would we call that? That would be his net in the transaction. Well, sellers have a gross and a net too. The sales price is the seller's gross. The amount they walk away from closing with is their net. Which do you think they care about in the grand scheme of things?
The net.
The net. If they don't, they're looking at the wrong goalpost. I said this to a seller one time in a listing presentation. He said, all I want to know is how much do you charge? That's all I care about. My answer to him was, well, you care about the wrong thing. He said, what do you mean? I said, well, how much have other people charged that you've been talking to? He said, well, some say 4, and some say 5, and some say 6. I said, and what are you thinking you can sell your house for? He said, probably about $125,000. I said, okay, well, if I told you I could sell your house for $400,000, would you pay me a 12% commission? What do you think his answer was? Hell yeah! I said, so you're asking the wrong question, right? The question is not what I charge. What should his question have been?
What are you going to do?
How much am I going to net? Now, truthfully, obviously, I cannot sell his house for $400,000, but I use that to illustrate a point to him that what really matters to the seller in a transaction is a net. And that's an important conversation to have, not just for this math, but you're going to get in negotiations where buyers are going to do something called asking the seller to pay closing costs. And some sellers will go, I'm not paying the buyer's closing costs. That's the wrong outlook. Let me ask you a question. What's the difference to the seller if they get an offer for $105,000 with the buyer asking them to pay $5,000 in closing costs, or $100,000 with the buyer not asking for any closing costs?
It costs them a lot of money.
It's the same thing, right? Because the net is exactly the same. We as sellers should not focus on the number at the top of the funnel. We need to focus on the number at the bottom of the funnel. That's a seller net problem. So with that in mind, you might see a test question where they ask you to sort of engineer a sales price based on a net that the seller needs. In other words, how much money do you have to have, Mr. Seller, so I can figure out how much we need to sell your property for, how much we need to list your property for, and see if that number makes sense. This pie chart you have up here, is going to help your way of thinking when it comes to these seller net problems. There's no magic to this thing. It's just a way of thinking things. How, if I pull a pie out of the oven, before I start eating it, and I'm going to do that quickly when I pull it out, what percentage of it is remaining? 100%, right? If I eat a 5 or a 6 or a 7% slice of that pie, what percentage is left?
94,
95, 96% of that pie, right? Whatever the difference is between 100 and what I ate. Seller net questions work in exactly that same way. They are absolutely no different from that, because what you have is a pie where the real estate broker is taking a tiny little piece and the seller is left with the remainder, the big piece. And that's how you have to think of it. Because what you're going to do is divide the amount of money that the seller needs by the seller's share of the pie. Has everybody got that? I'm going to say it one more time. The math of a seller net question is going to be to divide the money that the seller needs by their share of this pie as a percentage. So let's look at one right here. It says Leslie is listing a home for sale at 215 St. Giles Street in Raleigh. And the seller has agreed to pay a 5% commission. Assuming the seller must pay off a $150,000 mortgage, how much do they need to sell the home for in order to satisfy Leslie's commission and break even on the sale? So how much money does this seller need? $150,000, because they've got to pay off that loan. Would you agree with that? Now, the seller's got a nice pie baking, and they're going to get a big piece of it, but are they going to get the whole thing? No, because Les is going to take out a 5% slice, right? So what does that leave the seller with? 95%. Now, what did I say the math of this thing was going to be?
Divide.
To take the money that the seller needs and divide it by the seller's share of the pie. So how much money do we say the seller needs here? $150,000 divided by what's their share of the pie? 95%. So what do we need to sell that property for in order to satisfy those criteria?
$157,894.74.
Now, I'm going to point out something to you. Because you think you're slick, you're not. How many of you, let me put it back up. How many of you, when you see this question, think, oh, I'll just do this? Now multiply that. And what is that number? Tell me what that number is.
7,500.
It's 7,500 bucks, right? And then I'm going to go back and add that to the 150, and that must be the right answer.
No, sir.
No.
Is that number the same as that number?
No, sir.
Here's how evil they are over there at the Real Estate Commission. 1313 Navajo Drive. Both of those are going to be answer choices on the exam.
Of course they are.
You can't do it that way. And the reason this doesn't work is the 5% commission charged on the amount of money the seller needs, or is it charged on the total sales price?
Total sales.
And that's what you don't know, right? You don't know that total sales price. So that's why you got to do it my way and think of it as a pie, figure out how much money the seller needs, and then divide by their share. Does that make sense for everybody?
And so that's all they give you on the test, is the what the seller needs, not the whole, you know, the whole amount, like, and subtract the part that's missing.
Yes, for the most part. His question is, that's how they're going to give it to you on the test. Yes, but they might add a wrinkle. There's a wrinkle. Not much of one. But this is more how they might ask it on the exam. Scotty has listed as a home for sale at 115 Oak Street in Greenport. It is the only house for miles around with indoor plumbing. Y'all supposed to laugh. That's a Greenport joke. Assuming she and her firm charge a listing commission of 7%, the seller must pay off their $120,000 mortgage, $1,500 in closing costs, and have $25,000 left over to buy a double wide. What must the home sell for? It's the same thing. Give you a second. Mull it over. We complicated it just a hair, but not much, right? In this case, when we start calculating the amount of cash that the seller needs, do they need $120,000 to pay off that mortgage?
Yes.
They do. Do they need $1,500 to pay the closing costs?
Yes.
So what do you think we're going to do with that?
Add it in.
Do they need $25,000 left over to buy that double wide in the sky?
Yes.
All they have to do is add them together. So the total cash that the seller actually needs at closing is $146,500, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now check the math on that. Is that right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, seller again is not getting the whole pie because Scotty is getting how big of a piece?
7%,
which leaves how much for the seller? 93%. So what are we going to do with $146,500 over here? We're going to divide it by 93%. And what does Scotty need to sell that house for?
$157,526.88.
$157,500,
how much?
$526,000. Okay with that? That's as complex as they get. That's as complex as the math in this chapter gets. You can split commissions in that way, and you can do that seller net question. You can do the math in this chapter. Easy enough, right? Good. Good. Let's take a break, and then when we come back, we will talk about chapter 11. Short break.